Hello and welcome to Nine News WA First. Monica Koss with you. Chaos has unfolded at Banksia Hill Detention Centre overnight, with almost 50 teen inmates torching buildings and climbing onto roofs in a riot lasting more than 14 hours. The mayhem coming to an end when specialist officers used rubber bullets to bring the inmates under control. Mia Edgerton-Warburton was there as it unfolded.
The youth detention centre remains in lockdown after a night of mayhem. One inmate escaping his cell and then using a key to free 48 others. And then it was chaos. Multiple buildings torched, furniture up in flames, sheets tied together to climb fences, dozens making it onto the roof and refusing to come down, vaping and play fighting, blocking firefighters, some even using a buggy to ram property.
Together they have significantly damaged accommodation blocks and other infrastructure, started numerous fires and thrown debris at staff while on a roof.
After 14 hours, the specialist operations group moved in. Weapons drawn and shields up, they climbed onto the roof, the final few inmates slowly surrendering. Smoke bombs used to push them into a corner, rubber bullets forcing the inmates into submission.
Totally, utterly unacceptable. It's a form of terrorism they're engaged in.
The chaos began with a brick used by one juvenile inmate to threaten a female youth officer who was alone about 8:30 last night. Using keys left in a door, he unlocked other cells, those inside calling friends.
And then there was a whole like riot happening on the phone. I could hear like everyone screaming, saying, run, 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 run.
A specialist command centre was swiftly set up. The specialist operations group, assisted by WA police, including the canine unit. Six of the inmates involved in the riot, over the age of 18, some now moved to the controversial Unit 18 at the adult maximum security Casuarina prison. A dollar figure for the damage still yet to be determined, but the state government says this is a setback on a $100 million investment in the centre, now delayed for the foreseeable future. At this stage, it's unclear if the group will face any criminal charges. That decision will be made later after the Premier meets with the WA Police Commissioner.
And the Premier's held emergency meetings to discuss potential new measures to prevent violent outbreaks like this. State politics reporter Michael Genovese. Mark McGowan is defending the youth justice system.
He says the government is still very much in control of the Banksia Hill facility, but I'm going to quickly run you through just the last 6 months and I want you to be the judge. So on New Year's Eve, detainees torched buildings and armed themselves with riot gear, hurling projectiles at guards. A custodial officer suffered a suspected fractured skull just 2 months later. More violence in April. That was when union bosses sounded the alarm over pay and safety. And just days later, young detainees who had moved from Banksia Hill to the Casuarina Unit 18, they assaulted six officers. Today's chaos comes just a week after an officer was found guilty of assaulting a boy at Banksia Hill. This morning, Mark McGowan dismissed concerns over research that shows 30% of Banksia Hill detainees have fetal alcohol syndrome disorder. He called that an excuse, taking a hard-line approach to today's shocking violence.
Detainees have access to education, psychological support, recreation on any given day. They need to grab that opportunity. And all the people who make excuses are not helping them. You're not helping them.
Youth justice advocates have used today's violence to call for a different approach. They say that this tough love doesn't work.
There have been numerous points at which the government could have implemented a more effective and rehabilitative approach to Banksia Hill and to Unit 18, and they have so far failed to do so.
Now, the Premier has spent the afternoon meeting with the Police Commissioner, also the Justice Department, and at 6 o'clock we're going to have some more information about these new laws set to be introduced, Monica. These are going to be the ones that remove the adult detainees from Banksia Hill into the mainstream prison system. It's hoped that that'll make a difference.
Michael Genovese, thank you.